This is artist Jim Toia. He's harvesting black walnuts outside his studio in Long Valley, New Jersey.
Black walnuts for centuries were used to make ink, you know, before they started making it with chemicals. You let them rot a little bit and they form that beautiful ink, and all that ink starts to drip out of the cracked walnut shell, and all of a sudden you've got ink flowing. You just got to find the right surface that's going to receive that, and then it's going to do very similar things to what an inky cap mushroom does. There are plenty of other things in nature that do that as well. Almost all of the pigments that exist today started out as pigments coming from nature. You know, whether they were coming from a crustacean or from a flower or from a beetle. I mean, women's lipstick is still made out of beetles. Women don't realize that, but they are. We still have a lot to learn from nature. One of my favorite scientists, Buckminster Fuller, speaks about how nature is really the model that we should follow, because nature's been doing it for billions of years, right? And it's already figured out the best way to build things.
He came in one day and we met with the natural history staff, and we went through shelves and shelves and shelves of taxidermy birds. There's a woodpecker in this exhibition because the woodpecker was his co-creator in some of the works in the hallway. And we looked at lots of mushroom models. We have, the State Museum's natural history collection has mushroom models probably from the 30s or 40s, we think. And he went through all of them and he said, this is the kind of mushroom I use, and I don't use this one, and this, and he was telling us what the mushrooms give off. So he was looking at it in a different perspective than the way the natural history guys here look at it, which was very interesting for this crossover. That's what's interesting about this show for us. We have a natural history collection and a fine art collection, so this was the perfect marriage of both of those. The jellyfish are a surprise. Even when they're in there, sometimes they're hidden, you don't see the jellyfish. So there's always this, what's going on in the natural world that you're not seeing? You know, I think that's the element of it, and the element of surprise. These two things that shouldn't be together, a log and jellyfish, should not be together. Mushroom spore should not be on paper. I mean, all of his work is about surprise.
Over the years, Toia has developed a way to create what he calls spore drawings. To really appreciate them, you have to see what goes into making them, starting with going on a mushroom hunt.
Mushroom spore get sent out into the air, right? And they float forever, you know, many of them never settle. So they're in the air all the time. Every breath we take, from the first breath to the last breath, you know, we're gonna have, there's probably a couple of mushroom spore in there.
That looks very shiitake-like. It's not, but that'll spore white. So there's probably more back down here.
Based on what type of mushroom I'm either cutting or trimming or just separating these mushrooms, and then just intuitively laying them out on paper. I found if I try to think about or decide on a composition beforehand, that it almost never works for me. Once the spore are ejected out of the mushroom gills, these things, if the timing's right, they're gonna eject at the same time over, you know, 2 or 3 or 4 hours or even more. And then they're gonna flow together in whatever little air current or air pockets are happening in that tent underneath. Spore are too small to see, so you never know. We got a pretty good result for the amount of time that those mushrooms spored. And then I decided I want some more sporing to happen on that paper, so I laid mushrooms back out. And we had gone and found some more, so I added that collection to the process. So we'll see what happens now. looks more like a photograph than it does a drawing. You could call it a print because it is, you know, something getting, you know, transferred onto that paper. Everyone is different, so, and I think that the love of that for me is that I can never truly anticipate what's going to happen. So everyone is a gift. I think it gives people the opportunity to contemplate nature on a different level than they usually do. Nature or some circumstance beyond my control took the lead and allowed me to respond to it. So I became very interested in that, in circumstance and contingency as the, you know, kind of the blood coursing through the veins of my work. So that's always been a huge thing for me. And it just translated towards, you know, if that's what I love to do, if I love to be out there, why not make my work about that?
The New Jersey State Council on the Arts, encouraging excellence and public engagement in the arts since 1966, is proud to co-produce State of the Arts with Stockton University, New Jersey's distinctive public university. Additional support is provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation,